This is your daily devotion for March 27th. Behind me is construction of an apartment building about two blocks from my house. I think it's nice to see that construction hasn't halted in this time of so many things stopping. People still need homes. They still need a place to live. In John chapter 14, Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going to prepare a place for you." I have a vivid memory from my childhood. I suspect some of you might have a similar memory. That when I heard these verses, I pictured Jesus sweeping and redecorating a room for me. It's not actually a terrible interpretation. It reflects the main point, which is that heaven is prepared for us because of Jesus. But a little more context about these verses helps us to see in greater detail what Jesus did to prepare heaven for us. This chapter is part of a five-chapter section in which, well, it's basically a long extended quote of Jesus. It's really wonderful. It takes place in the upper room. Jesus and his disciples are celebrating the Last Supper. And it's the day before Jesus is crucified. So do you understand? When Jesus said, "I am going to prepare a place for you," he was talking about what would happen the next day. He would prepare heaven for us by offering himself as the perfect lamb of sacrifice. And Jesus tells us here that this is a reason for us not to let our hearts be troubled, for us not to be afraid. There are some horrific stories right now coming out of England about family members not being able to say goodbye to their dying loved ones except through video chat. That's really heartbreaking. And I pray that none of you experiences something like that in the coming weeks. But friends, when a fellow Christian dies, no matter what the circumstances, we have tremendous comfort. We have the comfort of knowing that it's guaranteed that a mansion, a heavenly mansion, is open to them, that heaven is open to them, because it depends not on anything they've done. It depends only on the work of Christ. If you have a fellow believer whom you love who dies in these coming weeks, perhaps it will happen in a way that you will not be able to see them in their moment of death. But you will be able to see them in an eternal moment of life. Today we have a couple of intercessory prayers. John Elliott is being transferred from the VA hospital in Minneapolis to the one in St. Cloud. As I understand it, it's in preparation to handle a surge of COVID-19 cases. But this will definitely be a hardship for John. He's made some relationships at that hospital, and it'll be starting out new in a strange place. We also pray for Kathy Hostrider. Kathy is an ICU nurse here in St. Paul. We pray. Dear Jesus, please be with John as he moves to a new place. Help him to form relationships and be comfortable. And as soon as possible, Lord, we ask that you allow his family to visit him. And Lord, we ask for your protecting hand on Kathy. Bless her valuable work as an ICU nurse. Give her the energy and the courage she needs to do this incredibly important work. Amen. I have decided, hope you can hear me over that equipment, I have decided that I am going to take weekends off from these video devotions. So there won't be anything on Saturday, but of course on Sunday you will have a video worship service to watch, posted by 9 o'clock. Don't be afraid. There is a place for you, prepared by Jesus. Amen.